Hello guys, welcome to Sonos KB. Today I'm going to show you how to install web GUI in WSL2. For this I'm going to use this webmin, and for this I have created this tutorial. So let's watch. I'm going to install this in my Ubuntu instance, and for this let me check the version of the OS. So it is 20.04. Let's copy the first command. It's adding webmin to source list of apt-get. This is the command. In the bottom we have to add the line which we have copied from there. This is the line we have to add. Let's add in the bottom of the list. Control X, then save. Okay, now we're good to go. Next command is webmin pgp key downloading. Let's download it from the link. You can see the key is downloaded. We have to add this key to the system. Let's add it by this command. Okay, now we are able to add this into our system. We have to run apt update so that this added key can be added in the list. It will take some time. It's done. Now let's install it by sudo apt install webmin. We run the command. You have to press Y. It will take some time. I first fast forwarded this thing so that time won't take much. Now we can access this by this URL, but we are not going to use this URL, we are going to use the IP. Let's test it by curl. Curl is failing. I think the service is not started. Let's see the IP address. Let's see netstat whether the port is enabled or not. No, 10,000 port is not enabled. So let us check what else. Let's
see the process from the PSEFL. Webmin is not running in the process. So as we can see, the process is not running automatically, so we have to make it manually. For this I'm going to make one more video where I can show you that how to restart the service automatically in the startup of WSL2. See, I have restarted manually and we are able to see in the process now. The PID is there. Let's see the if config. The IP address of the system is this, or WSL. We have to access it from the other web browser with 10,000 port. It will prompt us for the username and password. We have to take the username and password from our WSL2 instance which we have created. This is the username, Sonos KB. We can copy from here or just we can type it. So let us type and the password of the Sonos KB. Wow, now we can see the WSL2 web GUI, wherein we can change as many as settings we want to change from this GUI or web UI. You can say the webmin is one of the good tool for Ubuntu, Linux, anything you can manage from this tool. We have many options here. We can sign out from here. Sonos KB is the username. We can edit system settings. We can see the running process, users and group we can change from here. We have many options, networking, firewall, time, anything which you want to change, disk drive you can change from here, anything you want to modify. This is a very great tool. Be there. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel if you like my video. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.